Thank y'all for listening, and I know a lot about fear and a lot about faith, but I'm trying to overcome a lot of fear with faith in God. And we have to fake it until we make it. You know, the saying, fake it until you make it. Well, why not fake it until we make it, and have faith that you will make it, that we all will make it. And Jesus Christ is the key, and he's the only key. There is no other key, you know, that will get you through. I've tried other keys in other ways, and I can tell you he's the only way. And I thought about the song, Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness, Lord unto me. And also Semper Fidelis, which is the Marines, Semper Fi, and it means forever faithful. And God is forever faithful to us, though we may lose our faith at times. But you got to remember that your blessing, your healing, your restoration, your miracle from God is in transit. Just like if you order something from FedEx, you know, you trust that you're going to get that new top, or you're going to get that pair of shoes. And you only need to have faith. Don't be afraid, don't worry, don't fear, your miracle is there. When you choose to have fear or faith, faith in God. Fear and faith both ask us to believe in something that we can't see. Fear says, you'll never be happy again. You won't get that job. You'll never get married. Your marriage won't be restored. You won't get better. They don't want you around. But faith says, better days are yet to come. I'm going to find a husband or a wife to share my life with. I'm going to get that job I prayed for. My child will come home. I will overcome my addiction to drugs, alcohol, cigarettes, whatever your addiction is. Faith will bring you good things. Fear brings negative things into your life. Quit inviting defeat in your life. Have faith and invite victory in your life. Fear will keep you awake at night. Faith will help you sleep tight. Trust God. Fear and worry are of the devil. God has the final say. Be strong and of good courage. When fear comes to your heart's door, let faith in. Let God answer it, as they say. When the devil comes, let God just say, Jesus, get that for me, and he will. God is the answer. God is all we need. God's plans for you and me are good. And then we have Isaiah 41:10. So do not fear, I am with you. Do not be dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you and help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. Matthew 66:25. Therefore I tell you, don't worry about your life, or what you'll eat or drink, or about your body, or what you'll wear. Is not life more than food, and the body more than clothes and cowboy boots? Look at the birds of the air. They do not sow or reap or store away in barns, and yet your heavenly Father feeds them. Are you not much more valuable than they are? Matthew 17:20. He replied, because you have so little faith, truly I tell you, if you have faith as small as a mustard seed, you can say to the mountain, move from here to there, and it will move. Nothing will be impossible for you. And a couple of quotes. Faith is at its purest when we have nothing else to lean on but Jesus. 2 Corinthians 5:7. For we walk by faith and not by sight. And take heart, your faith has healed you. Matthew 9:20. So I guess the whole message is sometimes I personally, I'll be afraid of everything, and I'll say, I'm afraid. And we need to say, you know, I have faith. I know it's going to be okay. And really, really walk by faith and really believe it. You know, it's easy to say keep the faith, but we really do need to keep the faith, and we need to be as faithful to God as He is.